Hey guys, my name is Fabe and welcome back to another episode in a dinosaur mine. We are right here on top of our visitor center, which hasn't made a lot of progress since last episode. I'm a little bit on a blockade, I guess. I'm not really sure where to continue now. I really want to add the glass windows, but we have to wait for 1.7. But good news, guys, we are on a new version. Does it say? I don't think it does it? On the right? No, it does not, I don't think. But we are in build 6.4.1 of the Fossils and Archaeology Revival mod. And there are not many new features. I think there are one or two little fixes, but nothing that concerns us. However, this mod, this build of the mod, enables to switch over to 1.7, because if you would have switched to 1.7 before you had this build in your world, I think something like all your items vanish, or maybe even some of your dinosaurs from what I've heard. I don't know exactly what happens, but I'm definitely very happy. Where's that spider that I hear? It's so loud. Is it down here? It's probably below. I'm definitely very happy that we didn't switch to 1.7 yet. There you are. So now they are officially working on the 1.7 stable builds. So the next build should be a stable 1.7 build, and I'm excited for that. So we can do a lot of stuff once we have 1.7. We can add all the stained glass in the windows here, which will... Oh man, I should probably start gathering sand. I guess I gather quite a bit of sand, but I'll probably need a bunch more. So this is gonna be awesome. We can finally start and go fishing for name tags and finally name our dinosaurs, which is gonna be epic as well. And much more. We could go exploring for the new biomes and new stuff. I haven't gone exploring in this world since, I guess, in episode 50, we explored a little bit since we went back to spawn, but not really. It was kind of the same path that we took in the first episode. So I barely ever went exploring in this series, so I'm excited for that. Leave our house here, leave our park, and see something of the world, huh? Alright, but there's one thing. Oh, let me quickly show what I did since last time. Before we head on. I did a little bit of work. Look at this. Is it the whole... Yeah, it's the whole helipad. The only thing that's not built yet is the supports down there, because that requires a lot of carpenter's blocks. And I've been chopping down a bunch of trees too, to get some wood again, and I don't need as many as on the other side. I mean, I need some supports there going into the sand. I don't really need one on this side. Let's check out the other side here. But yeah, as you can see, I've done a little bit of work off camera. Yeah, we need one over here. I need to get rid of this tree probably. Not quite sure how I'm gonna do that. And I don't even need a support here. So we only need two supports really. So that's not too much. I can do that. Oh! It looks like we have still some wild Pachycephalosaurus. Actually, now that I mentioned it, I think I saw one roaming around somewhere in the desert the other day that we might have to get rid of. So, might have to turn your eyes away. Oh, there he is. You see him? Down there, hiding below the bridge. He is quite big already. He's grown. You are not one of mine, are you, guy? You didn't just break out. 16 days, pretty old one too. He's a little hungry. So, I'm sorry. I can't. I have to. Look away. Oh, you didn't see that. I don't want them running around eating all my trees up. And I think that's the one that I saw a couple of days ago in the dodo enclosure, actually. Because this tree in the dodo enclosure suffered already again, too. Yeah, these eggs that the guys lay... Oh, no. Oh, yeah, that was him. Look at it. Tree almost halfway gone again. And it sure wasn't those dodos. See another small one here right now? Ah. They are really like a plague, and there's another small one up there. Wow. Can't believe how well they are doing. This pig is still alive, so Diego's still busy with our... Oh! Got some company now, huh? A sheep? These mobs keep finding their way into Diego's enclosure. But he doesn't care. He only cares for the dodos on the other side of the road. Alright, let's quickly sleep the night away. And then we're gonna check on our Dilophosaurus and see how he is doing. I haven't checked on him in a while, and we wanna observe him and see if he dies in there still, or if it's finally completely safe. Oh yeah, earlier I saved one of the Pachycephalosaurus, I think it was Spot, from the little sand hole that is next to this little water pond. They keep getting stuck in there. I might have to get rid of that. We might do that a little later. But for now, let's just do a quick check. If he's... Oh! You seem alive and where... Oh! Oh! That was not a nice sound! You didn't die, did you? No, he's still alive. Was he after the cow? Well, there are enough chickens. Certainly, he should have enough hunger. Let's check him. Look at these cows just walking up here. He's big. Health? Okay, he's doing great on health. Hunger a little low, but still alright. I'm not sure. Yeah, he's after these cows. Maybe I should. Cows, get out of his enclosure. He's getting distracted by you. He needs to hunt his chickens. He can't concern himself with you guys. Taking a bath. Well, he's doing fine so far. There's a chicken coming close. I'm gonna check on him later, I think, off camera again. See if he needs some food. But so far, I want to test if he can sustain himself for a while. Yeah, so I still get comments from you guys asking me about the helicopters. And last episode, I got a comment asking me if I... So, I mentioned that earlier. Earlier, I got a lot of comments telling me to install a helicopter mod. And I said I'm not going to install another mod probably until episode 100, which is about, 29 episodes away. So, not too far away. But it won't be a helicopter mod, I can tell you that much. But still, I might try and build some sort of a helicopter. What is going on with these mobs today? You down there, skeleton? Surprise! Oh, I still haven't lit this up. Actually, I could gather a lot of sand from down here. No one would notice, right? So that's a good thing. Was there anything else? I could have sworn there was more that I wanted to mention. Oh yeah, lately I got way fewer comments than you guys used to give me. So I don't know, maybe it's the school that's going on right now. Maybe you guys are all busy. But I noticed that the views were a little less too, but that's normal. But I was a little surprised that you guys had less to say to me. Bob's doing... And that's not Bob, that's Hank. We haven't checked on Hank in a whole while, but he seems to be doing fine. I can't really check him, sadly. And Bob seems to do well, too. Yeah, he's dived in his enclosure. Ah, I just had to think about the 1.7 transparency update again. Once we are in 1.7, we can't look through the eyes anymore. But guys, I think I'm gonna do some work. I'm not sure where. I'll probably finish up the helipad. So we can call that done. And I might work a little bit on the floor of the visitor center. Another question that I still have is, what should I put here? I mean, I think a tree would look nice here, but a tree would cover up the whole building. If you stand here, want to look at it, and there's a giant tree in your way, that wouldn't be... Nice, and we already have a fountain down there, so I don't want to have a second fountain here. So, if you guys have any ideas, now's the opportunity to help me out. I might maybe put some smaller plants there. Maybe a little statue, but a statue would be too big too, again. Yeah, I have to figure something out. Alright, let me do some work, and I'll come back to you when I have something to show off. There it is. Supports for this helipad are done as I expected. It was a lot easier since there's sand all over the place. I only had to build this and only half the way, only up to here. And I think the one on the other side was even less. Yeah, just this tiny bit here. I guess I could add one more. I could just add sand there. And it might be easier. Oh, no, I said sand. That might be easier and might even look better. Yeah. That works, that works. We won't be able to see it from this angle anyways. But yeah, I don't have too much time for today's episode and not for Saturday's episode either, because I'm writing an exam on Friday and I gotta study for it, gotta revise all the stuff. Yep. Yep, that's what you have to do when you're a student. One more year. One more year and then I'll be done with that. Done with exams. hopefully sooner than later. But yeah, I had an idea while building here. So if you connect these pathways of the helipads to each other, we kind of get the outline for the pathways we could use within the building. And this pillar actually fits in quite well. I wasn't sure if that would fit in well, but it should fit in. And we can just do have some quartz on me. We are getting low on quartz already again. I still got some quartz ore, I guess. So not processed quartz. But our blocks, not looking good. Not looking too good. We might have to go quartz hunting again sooner or later. But yeah, so this could be some sort of a portal. And maybe I could close off the wall here. I'm not exactly sure in what manner I want to do this. So is this the center? Looks like the center, right? So let's maybe put another pillar in here. And to make it symmetrical, we are gonna have to put a pillar over here too. So it's I'm gonna make maybe even inside windows. So you can't walk you can walk through here, obviously, through the helipad, but you won't be able to walk through here. Or through here, maybe I'll add some glass in there so we can have, I don't know, some sort of room here, but we can observe the T-Rex skeleton in the main hall from this room. I think it would be nice. Maybe we can build some long tables, some chairs here. That would be kind of nice. Yeah, I think it would be cool. And we can replicate this. And this structure here, I built that way back, and it's still, I guess it fits in. Let's fill it in with some quartz here, I would say. I think that works out quite well. Better than I anticipated when I built it. And up there, I wanted to build a second story later on. So this is gonna be a very tall room here, which is gonna be nice, I think. Nice and open feeling. And we have to do the same thing on the other side. So going over here, I would say. Yeah, it seems about right. So yeah, I can the more I'm working on here, the more I can already picture how it's gonna look eventually. I think in the original Jurassic Park movie, if you saw it, there's this one scene where they sit in the visitor center with a bucket of ice cream. I think it was kind of the end of the movie before the raptors came in. Spoiler alert, by the way, but if you haven't seen it, but I guess this movie is so old. If you haven't seen it, you probably don't worry about spoilers anymore. And I kind of picture a room like that with like nice big tables, maybe even a buffet. Is that a word? Is that right pronounced or is that a wrong pronunciation? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. It's French. I don't know French. But yeah, I think that's going to look really nice once it's done. So we're going to have these hallways here and then maybe a door into this room. And maybe another room back there of some sort. So once again, if you guys have any ideas, let me know. You don't have a world download of this, so you can't really build it. I mean, if you are really eager, you can probably replicate the room size and see what kind of room would fit in here. But I would already be happy if you just have an idea without building it yourself. Always looking for ideas. I think that's the hardest part. Coming up with new ideas every single time. And what did I want to do? Oh, I'm out of stone, so no more stone slabs. There's one more thing I want to try concerning our Pachycephalosauruses here. So, there are certain things that have been in this mod pretty much forever, since before I played it. And I haven't played around with those yet. And one of these things are these ancient seeds. I don't know what they are called. We'll find out here soon. But I got quite a bunch of them, I believe. Yeah, these fern seeds. I saw Poet using them once. And I saw that they spread quite a bit. So I don't want to just plant them somewhere in nature and come back the other another day and have just the whole world covered in these seeds. Because I don't think they look really nice. They look kind of a little bit ugly. But I think some of you guys actually mentioned it in a comment a whole while back. Probably like, I don't know, 20 episodes ago or something ridiculous like that. That dinosaurs can actually eat these fern seeds. So I want to bring some sand too. Let's snag some sand from somewhere maybe. Is there some free sand? And yeah, I don't want to disrupt the landscape too much. I guess we can take some sand from inside of our visitor center before we put I only need like, what, 3-4 pieces. I want to fill in the hole basically, so that the Pachycephalosaurus don't get stuck in this one high anymore. Because every time they do, I get... Let's see, is that a message still? Yeah, Pachycephalosaurus doesn't have enough space to grow. I get these messages whenever one gets stuck there. And I'm glad that it says that instead of letting him grow and then suffocate. But on the other hand, I don't know why they still have only this one high hitbox. Why can they even get into this one high space, I wonder. Wait, isn't there an F3 command to check hitboxes? Was it like F3 and B? Oh yeah, there we go. Look at this. He has a very, very high hitbox. If you look at him like that. But for some reason... Look at this. Wait, this egg has an hitbox up there? Can I... This is weird. I never did this with eggs before. Or maybe the hitboxes are just screwed up. Is that what it is? So if I... No, I can't pick it up in this hitbox. Yeah, so this is not the actual... Wait, now it vanished? I had this happen before to me. It's so weird. Is there... Well, this is... Oh, no. Is it here? It is somehow in this block, isn't it? Is it? Oh, there it is. Found you. Invisible eggs. Wow. Yeah, these are still kind of glitched, especially on... Okay, let's get rid of these. Oh, wait, this is another egg here. Man, that's a good way to find hidden eggs, huh? We are on an Easter egg hunt now. Okay, I found you. Okay, let's get rid of this dirt pillar. Don't you? Yeah, let's get rid of these hitboxes again. They are not the prettiest thing. I mean, they can be useful, but... Am I gonna punch you if I... I wanna punch you. Is that it? Okay, that's it. Yeah, okay, I guess I gotta fill this in. Let's see. Okay, it's not falling. So now they can't get stuck there anymore. At least something. Okay, let's try and plant... You know what? I might only plant one of those and see how it behaves. Wait, I can't plant those here. Do I have to... Do I need a hoe? Do I have to tilt the soil to plant them? As I said, I have never played around with those, although I'm playing this mod now for over 70 episodes, and this was in there before I even started playing, and I never even tried it once. But if they need tilted soil, then I would wonder how they would spread over grass. Mysterious fern seeds. But let's try. Let's try if we can get it planted with tilted soil. Wait, did I... Yeah, there's still melons in here too. That's maybe why these little guys survive so well. Okay. And? No. Is there a trick to it? I thought you could plant them just on the ground. They are fern seeds. Do I have to cultivate those first? That's what I'm asking. Is it like the Palyraphy saplings that are fossilized before? They have to cultivate the fern seeds first. Let me try and put them in a cultivator, but I don't think so. I don't know. If that doesn't work, I'm probably gonna go to the wiki and look it up. Okay, let me look it up real quick, guys. I'll be right back. Oh, interesting. So the wiki says that it's getting nighttime and should sleep. No, that's what I say. The wiki says that ferns can only grow below leaves. And so it didn't specify how far below under leaves. So let me try and see if these leaves that are up there in the palm trees and the palaerophy trees are sufficient, or if the leaves have to be further down. So I guess it's kind of a, what is the term for that? Kind of a shadow plant? No, shadow. There is a term for that. I don't remember it quite now, but let's see. So there's a leaf right here. Oh yeah, I can plant them here. Interesting. Okay, let's just leave this one guy here and let's see what happens to it over time. It's gonna be probably a little bit of a long-term observation. If it doesn't get eaten by these guys immediately, guess we'll find out. I'm gonna leave this here and we'll check back later to see what happens to it. But yeah, unfortunately, I think I gotta already end it here. I know we didn't make much progress here today, but as I said, I gotta use my time to prepare myself for the exam on Friday. So I'll probably won't have a lot of time until Saturday, and I'll probably have to episode recorder until Saturday already. So these two episodes might be a little bit shorter, a little less progress, but I'm still planning a lot of stuff. I mean, that's something I can't turn off. Whenever I walk around, or if I'm just sitting somewhere, even when I'm studying sometimes, I'm still, half my brain is still thinking about these worlds and what I want to do next. Because these ideas come throughout the day, anytime. Sometimes in the shower, sometimes while I'm sleeping, sometimes while I'm walking to uni. So that's a good thing. So I definitely will put my thought process into this building further on, even if I don't have the time to play. But yeah, hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like on the video. I would really appreciate that. Helps me out a bunch. And I hope to see you all again in the next episode. Until then, have a nice day. And seriously, guys, don't be daft. Play some Minecraft.